Starting this section and the next couple, we're going to start to look at the Docker client or Docker CLI inside of our terminal a little bit more and learn about some of the very basic commands that we use to interact with Docker containers and images. Now, fair warning here, some of these sections are going to be a little bit boring because we're essentially just going to be typing in commands and looking at the output that comes, but I'm going to do my best to make sure to share a lot of interesting information with you along the way. So let's get to it. The first command that we're going to look at is one that we ran very briefly before. It is a command that we're going to use to run, to create and run a container using an image. So at the command line, we're going to execute docker run and then the name of the image that we want to use as the basis for this container. Now we've already gone through this process once before. At the command line, we ran docker run hello-world. And then we saw that message appear on the screen. Now, using the knowledge that you now have about what a Docker container really is, I want you to think about what probably just occurred when we ran that command. Chances are that somewhere on our hard disk is an image that has that file system snapshot with one single program inside of it. Maybe that thing is called, I don't know, Hello World. Who knows what it's really called? So when we executed Docker run Hello World, we took that little snapshot of the hard drive. We stuck it into this little container thing, or this kind of grouping of resources, and then we executed the command run hello world. And so the running process up here was hello world, that thing ran, and then eventually exited. So that's what is happening behind the scenes when you execute that command. Now there's a lot of variations on this docker run command, and a lot of very small subtleties around it, so let's take a quick pause. We're going to come back to the next section. We're going to start looking at some of the interesting features around the run command. So I'll see you in just a minute.